barely now with 15 HP. This is quite a scary position to be in. Hopefully he'll be able to find some good loot here as he opens the chest behind this drop.
Wow, I was just about to say, I think it's over for Medain, but look at this, Doko is hunting. He chased him all the way across Authority. I believe it was Doko he was fighting earlier.
Yeah.
Followed him on the jump pad, I think, right, Buster?
Yeah, he tailed him in. There's no way you're going to get away at that point. You know, these points, the Elims, they're worth so much, Fallout. You just have to get them when they're given to you like that.
Yep, I'm with Artox now, and hopefully this limb gets picked up quickly because I want to see what's happening with the two Simongrel engagement. That's going to heat up. This one's going to be very, very fast and aggressive as well. The European aggression continues. On board now with Artox at the disadvantage in total HP, only 125 to 175 of his opponent. Artox trying to do what he can to stay alive and to turn this around to change his fate here, Monster.
That's right, Artox represented for Germany here. Looking very good, trying to get the things going in his favor here. The swing through, he's gonna harpoon on into the box and the SMG follow-up, beautifully done. The thing about the harpoon is that it's silent when it comes down to taking those walls. So it's honestly down to the visual cue. You gotta pick it up and respond quickly.
Yeah, another BL member here. Listen to me, Hen. Hen, nice job getting a couple shots in. That's gonna be the elimination on El Jefe. He said, hey, I'm the boss around here. Tell the story for y'all as we start to understand where players are dropping, why engagements are happening, and we can start to predict what type of engagements may happen. You know, we know that Benji typically does like to drop over towards Loot Lake. He hasn't been dropping there recently. He's been switching up his drop position. Mongrel likes to drop Authority. He's been dropping over towards Caddy. So we'll try and predict that for you if we can. Meanwhile, it looks like Trulex is going to be right behind Nas and Toos nearby as well. We saw Toos get taken out over in retail by Riskar last game. I wonder if Toos is going to join the action here.
Looking like it right now as Nas is trying to do something to stay alive. No, this is not looking good for Nas. He's going to stay on a big 0 points here. Everyone he's crossed paths with definitely now, and Mongrel cranking up right now. This is such a bad idea. This is such a bad idea. Yeah. All the resources they're putting into this while the storm is on the move here. And look at that. Mongrel's going to get punished big time here. Granted, he does have the loot to get across here with the Shockwaves launcher, but this is a battle that he's already committed to. At this point, you might as well finish it. What's going to happen, though? If any of them get tagged one big time from their charges, that's it. The run's over. The game's up. The jig's up. Mongrel's on the lead here. He has the win. So this is a big decision for him to make to commit to. And no, he gets caught with the pickaxe out, and the Shockwave launcher exchanges hands, and Blake has the advantage now.
Yeah, beautifully called there, Monster. But again, that is such an investment right there by Mongrel. And to the point we made earlier, you have the best loot in the game. You just want to make it to late game. You don't need to go all in on those fights. And he went all in as soon as he used all of his materials to play for high ground. He started kind of flexing a little bit. And sometimes it's like an ego chow. You want to play for ego rights. You want to show that you are the better player. You want to play with confidence. I agree with that. But if you have Kit's loot, you just want to play smart. There's a difference between playing aggressive at the right times and playing smart. And right there, I think Mongrel definitely tipped that line. Meanwhile, Andalix gets a pick. Yeah, that's exactly right. So typically we see Authority, unlike Caddy's Corner, the Authority loot gets split. And actually teams, sometimes players don't even take the drum gun. They only take the grapple gun. So in this scenario, that is the case. We saw it yesterday with Chap. Liquid Chap was playing over in Europe and always had just the grapple gun and that Authority loot. And now we see ABN on our screen. An engagement against Castry. Castry known, speaking of Authority, known to drop Authority. Looks like ADN's playing with aggression against Bad Sniper. Castry's dropping Craggy Cliffs here, it looks like, instead, where he was playing earlier in a fight against some other players. We know players like Flick like to drop Craggy, not in this lobby this time around, but we do know Chapix was the player he took out earlier in Craggy.
That's right. Chapix is landing just near there as well, so definitely a scary spot to be. We talk about players like Mr. Savage not being in, so that's where that boat's available up in the northern side, though.
True. Yep.
Let's get to this fight here. It's ADN, man, just losing the exchange now against Pablo Wingu. Pablo is going to jump into the box. It's going to be a 180 turn. Can ADN hit it? And he does. The great tracking, even with the disorientation from the crash pad. That was well played for ADN. Beautiful tracking.
From Denmark, I think, if not Norway, somewhere in Scandinavia, I believe. But yeah, Denmark, Scandinavia in general, always well represented. CRR right now getting tagged up quite a bit. The new member of Fnatic. Big shout out to him. One of the few players from Wales. Welshman here representing Wales in the UK, seeing what he can do in this fight.
That's right. And let's not forget, guys, CRR has been here since 2017, since the earliest days of Fortnite. This time around, it's not going to be his best showing here as he gets taken out at the Authority. But I mean, this might be your opportunity to shine as Chrissy's trying to prove just that. And no, he's going to walk into some big shots. He's going to get the best, though. And no, it's not going to be enough. This Pans beats him with the AR. Almost, I think, always guarantee himself a victory or two. I think there's a stat out there. I remember from one of the previous tournaments. My gosh, that was crazy. If Aqua gets a victory at atmosphere of players like Dan and Aqua, who's off to his west hand side. And you try to figure out this rotate though. Firing shots over at Miro in front of him gave him that free cross here. Look at all the walls that were already built. The shield crack though is gonna happen right next to Miro. That's gonna be a bad sign for Benji now because he was sniped on his way in. Benji has to figure this out. Now he's gonna be the target of multiple players and he's not safe just yet. Sitting in the zone here, this is gonna start ticking for a lot of damage now. It's gonna start going up, it's gonna ramp up, and no, he can't get the safety. Miro takes him out. Benji from top 20th now, taken out in 64th place.
Or hunting rifle in your hands. Meanwhile, Castry also picked up ADN, so that engagement that we saw all the way earlier near Craggy did end up getting finalized, and it was Castry who ended up on top. So, man from the UK with a good start.
That's right, and let's not forget Lyzen here from console to PC now, putting the Slave Fest on. Definitely on the other side, though, Bad Sniper, one that we've seen make appearances on the NA East stage as well. The few that can play against all odds on other pings. Now that he's on his home turf, his home ping, his home server, you've seen how much easier it must be for him.
Bad Sniper, we had a chance to watch quite a bit in our last European Open tournament, coming from France, as a lot of those players in Grizzy are. NCES, Grizzy, so many French organizations, so much history in France, as that was the region that really started competing before every other region or area in Europe did. Last game, he got taken out, unfortunately, pretty early on. We'll see what he can do here in game number two. Only 6 builds left, so he has to play with aggression here, Monster. No crash pads either. It's going to be tough for him to do so. But he's actually, as I say that, going to be able to sneak right in. Just says, knock, knock. I'm going to enter right into your doorway. You don't have to invite me because I'm going to get this pick. He gets the elimination. Nice job from Leo. He needed that one.
That's it. He enters in. He's got the impact that he wanted and so desperately deserved there. And now we're back with Bad Sniper, who's in a much different position. But the door's also open here, too. And Crack has the entry key to walk on in. He didn't even need it because the lock wasn't slid on. And that's unfortunate as Bad Sniper gets taken out. And that's 2 back-to-back players who left a small entryway. And the pro decided to take advantage of it.
Did you hear about when Tom Brady walked into the wrong person's house in Florida a couple months ago?
How do you do that?
Yeah, that's what happened. He was trying to go to his offensive coordinator's house, and he accidentally walked into a stranger's house. Imagine Tom Brady's right there. That's what it looked like. Someone has the door open. Walked right in, waltz in simply. They're obviously unwanted in that house, and they get the elimination. Luckily, that same end result did not happen in Tom Brady's situation. He was all good. But nice job right there by those 2 players to sneak their way right on in like Tom Brady, the GOAT himself, did.
I was going to say, I think the only difference is, you know, you probably wouldn't be as upset, you know? You probably wouldn't be as upset.
Yeah, exactly.
back
I wish
to
Tom
Liza,
Brady would walk into my house.
Right.
For those that don't know who Tom Brady is, by the way, Tom Brady is like the Lionel Messi or the Ronaldo. I know you guys might not be Ronaldo, Cristiano Ronaldo fans, but he's like the Ronaldo or Lionel Messi of American football. The guy's the GOAT, one of the greatest of all time. He just walked into a stranger's house. Kind of funny. But we're back in the action here on board with Liza.
Yeah, and look, he's gotten all his points this game alone. That's going to be his 3rd elimination now. 22 points for him. On the other perspective, Rifla from Become Legends. The only representation here left now because Nos was taken out twice now in the early game. So can Rifla represent for BL or not? Lyzen, on the other hand, is doing well for himself and Team Grizzy. 25 points. This is a massive game for him. 15 just based off of Elims alone. The rest coming in the form of placements now. Big Cone here trying to do something massive. He's working underneath the distraction of the enemy, and yes, he's gonna walk through his 4th player now in a big come up. That's a flopper Haven there. He's got 4 in the inventory, 4 more in front of him. He's gonna give up all of the shields, and I don't blame him. That's a free pass to placement there.
Yeah, trying to rewrite the phrase. Good things come in fours, apparently, because he has 4 eliminations as well. Great job right now by Lyzen. Meanwhile, Become Legend's very own Rifla with 0 eliminations. He's going to find 1 peekaboo, former champion of the semifinal. It's going to be Squeezier. He's going to get taken out. 5 elims per game in the semifinal. That's going to be only 1 or 0 eliminations for Squeezier this time around. Rifla takes him out.
That's right. And no, Squeezier did have some elims, so we are going to see how he's going to stand the feed, too. It's going to be closer and closer now. Rifla going with the cheeky no-scope we've seen hit yesterday as well in the NA East Grand Finals, showing that anything can happen. You got to go for those shots in those heat of the moments, and now you got to go for these as well. He's going to find Kinzel to the stick over from the storm, and this is going to be the perfect situation now for him. Aquan Height is going to get cracked down. No shields, but Rifla can't do much about it. He's only got 100 builds.
Yeah, beautiful crack right there from Rifla. Can he get the finish? Nope, he's gonna try and finish someone else. It's gonna be Janice. Janus of Wave currently between a rock and a hard pace. He's actually tagged up quite a bit. Blake's going to get the limb. Keep in mind, Blake still has the mythic loot. Blake is the one that's knocking everyone into the storm with that shockwave launcher. So keep a close eye on Blake in this late game. Rifla going up and matching up against Liza. He looks like he's trying to take him out, trying to finish the limb if he can. Checks his high ground real quick. Smart check. He's going to get the pick on Enterprise's very own.
That was a great shot on Semexi now. Rifla turning up here before getting dropped. Possibly, yes, to Mazin. Liza, though, in the low ground. We've seen him get his fourth eliminations. He's found the fifth already on this rotate. What a crash pad. No builds. Change that, though. Aqua falls. And now he's got the mythic loot from Aqua as well. The grapple gonna play for height. And there is only one player up above him. It doesn't matter. He walks through Ref's guard as well. And Liza now at seven eliminations. Will he be able to take Mazin? He possibly will. And yes, he finds every AR shot that he needed. That's the eighth elim, 93 points, and it's a 1v1 low ground versus height here.
You gotta be kidding me. Liza doing his best save impression from last game with eight eliminations. He's actually gonna one-up him, and it's all gonna come down to this last fight. I believe our Aluka with high ground does have the shockwave launcher. I think he was able to take out Blake. I'm not exactly positive, so this should be Luka's game. I don't want to quote that necessarily until we can confirm it, but no, it looks like Luka's actually dropping towards low ground. It looks like we got a good old-fashioned fight here between these two. Who can hit their shots and who can clutch up?
And that's right, you saw Liza hitting some bait there with the grappler. It's not gonna be enough as Luka hits the shot.
But in first, Knight sticking up top there after two games so far. No victory royales for him, but his general placements have been third and 13th place on top of the eight eliminations he's gone. He has a pretty sizable lead so far. Shuzi is right behind him, though, in second place with a 16-point difference.